body back. Please.
Don't flatter yourself.
The giant's fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close. Boy. It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now. Hello? Anybody here? Who's the guardian?
I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened to them? Why'd Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
Wait! Father! Something's happening!
Thank you.
That's your axe. It's Muller. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She knew giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. But that just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain. The stone mason. All these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant. I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here knowing we would find this.
But why not just tell us the truth?
Your mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes. Yes, we are.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it.
Goodbye, Faye.
I love you, Mom.
giants. They really are all gone. There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. The giants called me Loki?
Loki? That's the name your mother wanted for you when you were born. She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
Guess it all makes sense now. Why she want to end up here? Deal with her kind? But did she know it was going to be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people? Or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. So why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
A great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope. That though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow! You actually told a good story. We missed it. I understand if you want to go home, but I bet there are still some corrupt developers out there that could be set free. Some other help people. Maybe helping people was part of why Mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh. That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Lads, am I glad to see you. I believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else?
Odin is extremely clever, you see. Nearly as clever as he thinks he is. And he's a collector of prophecies. If it's about the future, he adds it to his collection. Helps him style himself as all-seeing and all-knowing. But of course, the idea is control. Control of the future, control of his fate. He'd control every realm of every land in every world if he could. Every potential pocket of resistance, he seeks to eliminate. Even if you've never posed a threat before, he may think one day you might. So you see, it's not important how he knew before you did. It's important that he was right.
But is that snow?
Ash. It only falls like that for great fires.
The whole realm is a great fire. The source of fire itself. And all the sun and stars, if legend is to be believed.
Should we believe? I mean, we're here, and we're not on fire.
Not yet.
Well, you know, I suppose it's cooled considerably since the dawn of creation, hasn't it? Niflheim isn't exactly ice these days either. It's in the nature of things. Extremes are tempered by time. Fires burn colder, men grow old and grey. Heads are chopped off and attached to belts. Such is life.
Okay, Mimir. Almost like the heat, Brock.
Heat's damned useful in my line of work. Even makes space itself more pliable. Take those magic doors you love so much. Round here they all go right to one another. No prodding from old Brock. Go up yonder and wake some up, you'll see. Getting around moose pools a cinch. Long as you don't end up cooked. All right, what'd you break? See you next, whereas I see you.
Another.
This one's called Surtr. Must be a fire giant.
Aye. The first and original.
Come, boy.
Listen. I hear a voice.
Another elf?
I don't think so. It's coming from up there. The voice! It's just around this corner. Oh. It's a great big sword. No, ready to train? The gate's closed.
Prepare yourself, boy.
Yes, sir.
Brother, behind you! Careful behind you!
Prepare yourself, boy.
Yes, sir. treasure dump.
Wouldn't it be nice to find some incense just once? The smell of brimstone gets old quickly.
It says there's another level to this challenge. Harder than before.
Yeah!
back here.
level to this challenge. Harder than before.